Unmanned aerial systems, or UASs as they're referred to, are a rapidly emerging and disruptive threat on the battlefield of today. They've been used along with cruise missiles and tactical ballistic missiles to create a complex integrated attack that's designed to overwhelm the defensive systems that are on the battlefield today. I'm Bob Kelley from Raytheon's Land and Air Defense Systems. When these threats were first introduced on the battlefield, militaries had to respond with whatever interceptors they had available. In many cases, those interceptors cost multi-million dollars. And that produces a cost curve that's unsustainable for militaries in the long term. We determined what's needed is an integrated, layered, multi-tiered system that leverages both kinetic and non-kinetic interceptors to defeat this threat. A complex integrated attack is designed by an enemy to overwhelm not only your sensor systems, but also your operator's ability to deal with this numerous amount of threats that are coming in simultaneously. And coming in different ways: cruise missiles, tactical ballistic missiles, and UASs. What is really required to combat a threat like that is the highest quality sensors we can provide to the Army. And I would say that LTAMDS falls under that, KuRFS falls under that, and GhostEye falls under that. You also need the battle management aids to help an 18-year-old sitting in a van or standing on a hilltop with a Stinger missile on his or her shoulder to make the right decision. As our defensive forces evolve, so will the threats force. And so to have multiple types of interceptors really creates multiple problems for the enemy. And that's essentially what a commander on the battlefield wants to do. From a Raytheon perspective, on the kinetic side, we have the Coyote missile, which is essentially a friendly UAS that is fired to go out and attack an enemy UAS. On the non-kinetic side, we've got the high-powered microwave system and the high-energy laser system, or HELWIS. All three of those will flatten that cost curve, both for our US forces and our allies around the world. The LIDS system that's primarily in operation today to defeat these unmanned aerial systems, I think, is a great example of what the Army calls transformation in contact. I need a capability on the battlefield quickly. I do not have time to wait for a long development program. And I know what I put on the battlefield is not going to be perfect the first time, but I'll get it there quickly. Let them have a capability and then continually evolve that capability to meet the requirements of the warfighter. And so that's exactly what the Army did. They took an existing KuRFS, or KU band sensor, the tremendously accurate radar. They paired that with the Coyote missile, put it all together with an existing command and control system that soldiers were already familiar with, and they put it on the battlefield. We've continued to evolve that system to make it much more capable today than it was when it was first fielded in 2017. LIDS is the Army's system of choice, and it is combat proven. It has over 170 threat defeats, and there's really no one else out there that can say that. One thing's for certain: the threats that a second lieutenant in the United States Army Air Defense Artillery is going to face in 2025 are far more significant than the threats that Second Lieutenant Kelley faced in 1990 in the same role. I've watched over the past 30 years as these threats increased in velocity, increased in lethality, and increased in range. But I've also had, over that same time period, the opportunity to watch defensive systems evolve, many of which were created by Raytheon. Those systems ensured that the US soldiers and our allies had the best systems available to defeat those threats, and what we like to call threat overmatch, that we had the capability to defeat them. What always impressed me about Raytheon was the genuine care that their products worked and that soldiers were not going to be at risk when they were operating those. My soldiers and I, throughout my career, always had 100% confidence in Raytheon systems. And when we needed them to work, they worked. Since I've retired, I am very proud to be part of an organization that greatly increases the protection and mission accomplishment of our forces and of our allies around the world.